chub are known for a couple of things: their incredible shyness and their voracious catholic appetites. Over the years they've been caught on all things, from bread, worms, pellets, through to slugs, snails, and even chip shop chips I've heard of. I'm Mark Parker from Improved Your Course Fishing, and today you find me on the River Cherwell, where I've come to meet up with angler Mark Boyd. Now, as well as using the standard fare of, as I say, like bread and worms, this kind of stuff, Mark also likes to tackle his chub in a slightly different way, by using lures. So let's go and catch up with Mark and find out a little bit more about this exciting branch of the sport. Right, Mark, lure fishing for chub. I mean, this probably sounds a bit off the wall for some people, you know, because there's pike and perch, but chub, you know, can we catch them on lures? Are they that predatory?
Yeah, we can. I generally would use something quite small for chub, something like you'd use for perch, really. They are very predatory. Things fall off the banks, even small shrews and mice, chub will have them. Mm. It's not only the pike and perch that you know, nobble these things that fall into the river. You only have to throw in a slug on the right day or a worm, you'll see them come up and absolutely annihilate it. Well, they do the same with fish. And signal crayfish, they absolutely annihilate the signal crayfish as well. You know, they're one of the few species that, you know, are trying to keep the population down, but not managing. But, you know, with little lures, little jelly lures like these sort of things, that look very realistic and have a very realistic swimming method, it's they will absolutely hammer these things. Mm. You know, I've had chub heading on for £5 on these little lures.
Yeah, so that's, as you say, because they're very predatory. I mean, they'll munch little minnows and little fish roach.
Happily. They'll take quite big fish. And I said they'll take small mammals as well. Mm. You know, a big chub over £5, over £4 will take fairly hefty sized.
I mean, a fish like that, I mean, it's almost got like a mouth. Yes. You can get an orange.
Yeah, exactly.
So
exactly.
This is going to be almost like a chocolate mint to it.
Yes, it is.
So I suppose, is this the kind of thing that you tend to use? These little rubber shads, aren't they?
Yeah,
As you see, they've got quite a wobbly. You can imagine that in realistic.
They're incredible when they're in the water. When they're in the water, they're absolutely incredible. I used to use the MEPS style spinners, and still do. Where if it's fairly fast water, I like to use the leaf blade MEPS spinners and those sort of things to bring across the flow. But a lot of the sort of chub swims I fish tend to have a bit of depth. They're a little bit slower than the streams where I'd fish for sea trout and salmon with the MEPS, and these sort of things are great because you can jiggle them in really slowly without them getting snagged up. You can use little lead heads, various weights.
So this is how we attach them. You say we don't want attached here, but
just an example. You know, normally you might attach a little piece of thin wire if there were pike in the water, or if you were fishing a river or canal. You'd put something there to stop the pike biting you off.
Yeah, but it's always worth putting wire in because even in a little river like this, you still get a pike, and it's not fair for the pike in case it does bite it off.
Exactly. You know, you may put off the odd perch, but you know you can't risk
de-hooking a pike.
Yeah, exactly. And you know, you've got various weights of these hooks here, so for different flows more than anything, so you can get away with quite a light one. Make sure the hook's always protruding out the back, and then the fish can just bump along the bottom without getting snagged up.
And I suppose the ideal thing, as we can see on this one that's set up, is the fact that it's bouncing along the bottom like this, so it's almost weed-free as well.
Yeah,
so it's perfect in these sort of snaggy, exactly where the sort of chub live.
Superb.
And is this kind of the sort of colour you tend to use, these kind of more natural
I prefer the
colours,
more natural ones.
You know, rather than these sort of the more gaudy, because there are hundreds and hundreds of different types of lures.
To be honest, personally, I prefer the more natural colours. I do catch on these sort of colours, but it's just a personal preference and a personal feeling, I think. I do like to use the natural, something that looks like a minnow or looks like a roach. I feel more comfortable with it because I know the chub, perch, pike have all seen them before.
Yeah. Sight feeding.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And the action of them, you have to see them in the water, really. They're absolutely incredible. Mm. You know, it doesn't really do them any justice just giving them a little wiggle. Because they absolutely look incredible. And you can just twitch them and let them drop, and they do look like an injured fish. You can fish them with no weight at all if the water's slow enough, just with a large size 2 hook or something out the front of it. And, you know, it's just as effective. Mm.
And with that way, if you just did without the lead head, as I say, then you can float it down snag.
Yeah, that's it. The current will carry it down.
And sort of bring it back to you, this kind of thing. So various ways to fish it. Really, really, really effective.
Yeah.
So what kind of gear do we use? And I suppose, I mean, We don't need anything fancy, do we?
No, you don't. If you're fishing small rivers and canals, ideally a small lure rod, something around, you know, the 7 foot range, 7 to 8 foot is ideal. You could go to 9 foot, and then, you know, you can fish slightly bigger rivers then as well, and, you know, still have, not fall short on the casting really. Mm. Lightness is one of the main things, basically, because you're going to be fishing with it all day, walking around, covering a lot of miles, doing a lot of casting. So a small reel, ideally loaded with braid, because you've got no stretch then, so when a fish hits it, you're going to set the hook immediately, mm. as opposed to getting all the stretch that you'd find in mono if it's at the end of the cast. Mm. You know, you want your drag set fairly light again, in case you get a really savage take, just enough for you to be able to set the hook really. But yeah, lightness, fairly short rod will allow you to work the lure as well, and not having a lot of rod butt out the back, which makes it hard to manage. Mm-hmm. So you're looking at something like this. These little Savage Gear rods are, you know, they're made for the job. You know, they specialise in lure fishing, and you can see why.
Superb. And then I suppose finally, really, just how do we sort of bring these back? You know, we kind of cast one out.
Well, you can ideally, again, let it drop down, find out the depth of the water first, and then work through the different layers. So first of all, you might try a slow, twitchy retrieve along the bottom the first time, and you might cover the area around, and then if nothing happened, maybe bring it back higher up in the water column, mm. and keep trying it and try different speeds. You know, some days perch want something to be moving a bit quicker, mm. other days they want something to be just bouncing along the bottom. With the bouncing along the bottom bit, you might want to use something called drop shotting. Yeah. I set this up. It was a method that came in from America years ago. It hasn't taken off massively here yet, but on some of the larger pike and Zander waters, where they're fishing from boats, they can drop a lure down, and then you have basically the weight at the bottom.
Yeah.
You so attach the
suspends kind of in mid-water.
So you'd have the hook sitting out in the middle, and you'd have a minnow off it. Now what you do, you pull that taut, and then you let your rod drop, and the minnow would drop and flutter through the water, and then you jerk it up again. Mm. So it's almost like feathering for mackerel almost, but you're just making this little lure work like
and
that.
And this is something that the
Perch pike, love it,
and chub absolutely annihilate.
Yeah, because you can leave it in the one area, whereas with a lure
right
you've got to bring it past the area and then it's gone.
Yeah.
With this, you can leave it there for a few minutes, twitching it, and then you can just jig it along a little bit again.
So put it right in their lair.
Yeah, right in there, and you can leave it there, taunting them in front of their faces until they can no longer resist. But you know, and again, you know, they're pretty much snag free because you're bumping a round lead along the bed of the river or the canal or the lake. And you're just twitching it like
fantastic.
That. You know,
fantastic.
You can just doing that, you're getting movement.
Yeah. Well, so. I think you can see how effective that is.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's a really, really interesting and a really unusual way to tackle sort of small rivers for chub rather than the usual kind of haute de fer, as they say.
Yeah.
A really interesting way to do it.
Yeah, you can travel light and you can cover a lot of ground. Yeah.
Well, thanks for that today, Matt. That's really been really interesting. So, I've been Mark Parker from Improving Course Fishing. This is Mark Boyd. Remember to check out the feature in the magazine. Until next time, tight lines.